The September 2025 release of Maxon Studio brings with it two incredible new features, including assets and effect capsules. Let's talk about assets first. Since Maxon Studio was first released, people have been wondering, how do you get assets into Maxon Studio? That was not possible, but my friends, it is now. I have a composition here. I've got 4K raw red footage. I've got EXRs. I've got a wave music file. I've got an AI. I've got EPS. Anything you want to throw at Maxon Studio, it can handle now. So I can go into Maxon Studio and I can, which I can do from going to the window menu and choosing Maxon Studio or using the keyboard shortcut Control Alt Space. I'm going to go to the create page and I'm going to create a new capsule, making sure that this one is selected. Let me show you how this works because it's kind of fun. I'm just going to name this temp because this isn't going to be great. You know, it's just like a hodgepodge of footage. I don't really need to save that. But you'll notice as you're creating capsules, we have a new tab over here next to properties. We have assets. And this shows you all of the, whoops, I don't want that to float here. It shows me all of the assets that are in this entire composition, including nested compositions as well. Now, as if that wasn't cool enough to be able to have a list of included assets there and the ability to search through them and very quickly see what file format these things are. But as we highlight each asset, we get these two little buttons, one on the left, one on the right. And these are critical. Now, in my stupid little project here, you know, these buttons, the one on the right isn't going to be a total lifesaver because what that does is that it jumps to the thing in question. It jumps to the asset. So if I had nested comps with nested comps with nested comps and an asset buried super far away, like I had to do a bunch of, you know, riddles in order to find it, then this button becomes invaluable because it will jump you to that asset. Also, another thing that's pretty cool, especially for these like EPS files that are kind of tough to get a thumbnail for, it automatically generates the thumbnail for me and I could actually get a little clue of what's going on with these layers that I don't in my composition, which is pretty cool too. Now, the button on the left is magical. What it will do is it will convert this asset, the selected asset, convert it to a black solid. So like this is a piece of music that I got from a stock catalog. I don't have the rights for it. I can't distribute it. So I'm going to turn this into a solid so that in the capsule, when somebody else applies it, it's not going to carry the song and I don't have to worry about rights for that. Now, what is kind of cool is that we can still do the replace workflow. So I can drop an audio clip into my parameters area here, and then users can replace that. And it's easy just to drag and drop and replace that footage item here. And you know, I love that these are not mutually exclusive features. So in other words, I can convert this to a solid and replace it, or I could include it and then allow users to replace it easily as well. So the replacing thing is not really connected to the converting to a solid thing. They're two separate things. Now, when I create this capsule, all of these objects will be stored in that capsule. I don't have to worry about dependencies or links or anything like that. It's just gonna be in this capsule, which is fantastic. Now, I'm just gonna delete this for now. It takes a little bit longer to create capsules when you're storing a ton of assets in them. So just be aware of that. I mean, this one wouldn't take very long because it's very small and simple, but just something to be aware of. Now, sometimes, you know, when you have comps like this is this animation that I created and it uses this map that I made, this height field that I made in Houdini. And it also takes advantage of this like map from NASA, you know, it's a really cool outer space photo there. And so it kind of takes advantage of a lot of those things. And so if you're going to share a project like this and you don't include the assets, you know, there's a lot of stuff that kind of falls apart. So, you know, it's not just about kind of like storing a video or a logo or an audio file. It's also about making sure that like your effects work, that those dependencies carry over completely. So that's the ability to store assets is actually just like really an incredible thing that Studio can now do. Now, we're going to come back to this little example in Mir in just a moment, but let's talk about the other new feature, and that is effects capsules. Now, I have here this like combo of effects. I have particular, and it's just basically just a bunch of circles, and then I added bokeh to that to give it a little bit of bokeh look, and then I added some optical glow to kind of make that pop and really see all the details there. There's some animation and stuff like that. These twinkle little bits, really pretty. And a lot of times I want to create a series of things like this. I want to create a star field. I have a certain kind of combination that I like to use. And in this case, you know, I've got some effects and I've got some options here. So what I can do now is create a new capsule that's a different type of capsule. So normally what we have is called a layer capsule. It contains layers. And this is an effect capsule. It contains effects. So I'm going to select this layer. I'm going to go to the new button. I'm going to create a new capsule, making sure I have the correct comp selected. And here is this new but very important dropdown, create capsule from. The default is what we're used to, all layers in the selected composition. But what I want to do is use all effects in the selected layer. From here, of course, we can choose the layer. We only have one in this case, so it's, you know, no big deal. I could call this bokeh. And I can drag and drop parameters like I normally would here, and then save this as a capsule. Now, as you're going around doing your Maxon Studio business, now it's good to be aware that there are two types of capsules out there. I'm just going to delete this because I already created this before. I'm going to discard this capsule, go to Discover. And just to make this quick and easy, I'm going to go to this little filter here, and I'm going to choose to see just my capsules. So there's a couple effects ones, a couple layer capsules. I could select this one, and you'll now see that when you look at the details, when you select this, you select a capsule, it'll say capsule applies to a composition if it's a layer capsule. And if it's an effects capsule, it'll say the capsule applies to a layer. So if you get confused, just click on a capsule. It'll tell you whether it applies to an entire composition or whether it applies to just a single selected layer. Now, there's an extra bonus cool thing that you can do here, because a lot of effects that we have, like especially the red giant effects, for example, are extremely potent effects. And they're also kind of unusual effects, effects like Mir, where I took that, you know, black and white, the grayscale height field map and made this moon surface, and this is full 3D geometry with lights and cameras, responsive depth of field, as you can see. I mean, this is like some pretty cool stuff, but it does take a little bit to set up. And so if you're new to Mir and you don't remember how to set this up, it could be a little bit confusing. I also used Mir, this same effect that makes this three-dimensional moon, to make this yummy pouring chocolate effect. That's delicious. Every time I see it, I love me that pouring chocolate example. So that same effect that makes this moon makes also this pouring chocolate. As you can imagine, there's a lot of settings and a lot of things to change to get from the moon surface to this pouring melted chocolate here. And same thing with this. This is also Mir, this like big ball of faceted mesh. And then also this like three-dimensional water that moves around that you can kind of orbit around with the camera because it's actually three-dimensional mesh. And so for times like this, when you have effects that are super versatile and super powerful, then you can call on the old Maxon Studio feature of presets. So as an example, I can go to my empty composition. I will take the particular bokeh capsule that I've already applied. I'll go ahead and hit the plus button to apply that here. And then I'll move that out of the way. And maybe I'll fiddle with the settings a little bit. I have the star glow on here as well. Maybe I'll turn off bokeh and maybe turn off optical glow. Maybe I'll go into the particle settings, maybe take down the size a lot so that they're very small. Maybe I'll go to the emitter and then make this like wider and open up distribution and increase the particles a lot so it looks more like a star field. There we go. Yeah, there we go. And let's make this wider. So this is like a lot wider, like a star field. There we go. And let's make this like a little bit smaller, maybe like 2. There we go. And increase the size random, increase the opacity random. Okay, this is starting to look like a star field, or at least something that's like, you know, passable as a star field. And then what we could do is we can go into the star glow area here, and maybe we want to boost the lights of the stars that are star glowed. That looks pretty cool. Maybe we'll change the color map. We'll go down to lysergic. I don't know. It's interesting. And so now as these stars twinkle, which animation was there from the bokeh stuff, now we have twinkling stars. And then when stars get really bright, like this little guy here, they will go into star glow. They get a little bit of star glow applied to them. There we go. There we go. See that? So now we have a completely different variation, and we can go back to the edit page and find the applied capsule, go to the flyout menu, and save this as a preset. And then it will show up here under select preset. So in this way, we can really start to build up our library. So if you have an effect that you use only occasionally, like Mirror, but that does a lot like Mirror, where you're making 3D objects, you're making chocolate, you're making mesh, you're making your water, then you can go ahead and save all of these as their own preset that you can access from this drop down here by choosing select preset. Also, when you're looking at a capsule that is selected, then you'll see its presets right here. You can click the plus icon and apply the presets from here as well. Now, this also comes in handy, just be aware of this. It comes in real handy for effects like particular that have a designer, or like Magic Bullet Looks that has the looks pop-up window. So what I can do, these presets are hidden and, you know, difficult to access maybe from Maxon Studio. But what I can do is I can find, and this is a perennial favorite here, I could find, let's say, the boomerang thing, and I can apply the boomerang thing, and then I can save this as a preset, one of these presets in Studio. Go over here, save this as a preset, and I'll just call this boomerang thing. That's kind of a boring name, but okay, you get the idea. And now whenever I go back to this capsule, if I'm going to apply it, click on it once, there we go, boomerang thing is now one of the presets. And so I've basically taken it from outside of the designer and into an area that's much more accessible here in Maxon Studio. So on behalf of the entire team at Maxon, we hope you have a blast playing with these new features, embedding assets to your heart's content, and also playing around with effects capsules and presets with those effects capsules.